Hello everyone, this is Joanne and we are studying about the Korean for the test topic. So this is the sixth classes and welcome back to our class. Today we're going to study about type 4 of reading part. So type 4 is question like that, you know, you can find select correct sentence, so correct sentence about the story, short story. Okay, here we go. This is about the question number 43 to 45. Only three questions, but you shouldn't make a mistake, okay? Number one, let's read the question first. 다음에 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. Okay, here's a little short story in the box, and there are some four sentences, and then you should find which is correct about this. Okay? Alright, here we go. So I'm gonna read for you the story.
저는 매일 저녁 산책을 하고 학원에 갑니다. 학원 식당에서 저녁을 먹고 수업을 듣습니다. 그리고 커피숍에서 아르바이트를 합니다.
Do you understand the story? Understanding everything? Okay, here's some key word. I mean, little trick here. So first, you should find and how often. So here's key word, 매일. 매일 mean every day. But 매일 저녁 mean every night, every evening, every night. So what do I do every evening?
산책을 하고.
What is 산책? Just walking. Okay, go for a walk is 산책. Okay. So every night, every evening, I go for a walk and
하고
땡땡하고 mean and
학원에 갑니다.
학원 mean is in a private studying, private institute or academy. I go to institute every night, every evening, right? After walking.
학원 식당에서 어디에서 mean at,
right? At
저녁을 먹고
eat 저녁 mean in, I know here 저녁 mean evening. This is for about the time, but here 저녁 mean 냠냠냠 dinner, eat meal, so dinner. So I eat dinner. Where do I eat the dinner?
학원 식당에서 수업을 듣습니다.
수업을 듣다 mean 듣다. It's not about the listening, just listening. It's about taking a class. Okay, taking a class.
그리고 커피숍에서 아르바이트를 합니다.
You know what? 아르바이트? 아르바이트 mean part-time job. After studying, I work as a part-time job. Where do I work?
커피숍에서.
에서 always for, not always. Normally for the place. Sometimes the time, sometimes the places, okay? So we found all the information about this. Okay, let's find which is correct. Number one,
저는 저녁마다 산책을 합니다. 땡땡마다
mean every, okay? Every evening, every night, every morning,
저는 산책을 합니다.
Is it correct? Yes.
저는 매일 저녁 산책을 하고.
So you can find number one is correct. Number two,
저는 저녁을 먹고 학원에 갑니다. 저녁을 먹고.
This is first, okay? I eat
dinner, 저녁을 먹고 after I go to the institute. Is it correct? Look at here. The first one, 산책. Number two, 학원. Number three, 저녁을 먹고, 냠냠냠. Number four, 수업을 들어요. And number five, 커피숍에서 아르바이트를 합니다. So it's not correct, right? 저녁 is after when I go to institute, right? B. Number three, 저는 아르바이트를 하고 학원에 갑니다. So, 땡땡고 mean before, okay? So, 저는 아르바이트를 하고 학원에 갑니다. Is it correct? No, because I go to institute first after I taking all the classes. I take all the classes. After that, I go to the coffee shop for part-time job, right? So, it's correct. B. Number four, 저는 학원 식당에서 아르바이트를 합니다. 학원 식당 땡땡땡에서 아르바이트를 합니까? So what do I do at the restaurant and institute? And restaurant of the institute 학원 식당에서 저녁을 먹고 not part-time job. Eat dinner, right? And where do I work? Do I have part-time job? At the coffee shop, right? So it's not correct. So right answer is number one. So don't forget, 매일, 땡땡마다 is key word. It means every day. It's about frequency. So every day, once a day, all right? Okay, good. Number two. Okay, let's read the story in the box. 다음 주 화요일에 과학 시험이 있습니다. 그 시험은 아주 어렵습니다. 그래서 날마다 도서관에 가서 공부합니다. Alright, can you find the keyword? Keyword is about normally about the time or places or what do I do? Okay, what I do? Okay, so here we go. 다음 주. 다음 mean next, 주 mean week, the next week when 화요일, do you know when it's 화요일? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, that's right. So next Tuesday, so in English, we can say next Tuesday, but not next week Tuesday, right? But in Korean, we always say 다음 주 화요일. Or sometimes 다음 화요일 will be fine, okay? 다음 화요일, 다음 주 화요일 will be fine. So 다음 주 화요일에 땡땡땡이 있습니다. What do I have? 과학 시험. Do you know what is 시험? 시험 is test. That is important thing, right? Test. And what kind of test? What kind of subject of test do I have? 과학. 과학 means science, right? 그 시험은 아주 어렵습니다. How is the test? 어렵습니다. Difficult, right? Difficult. 그래서 so 날마다. Okay, here we go. 마다 again. What did I say? 마다 mean every, right? 날마다. Do you know 날? 날 is one day, two day, days, right? Every days. 날마다 도서관에 가서 공부를 합니다. 어떻게 한다고요? 도서관. Do you know 도서관 is library. 도서관에 가서 공부를 합니다. Study. I study. Okay, here we got all the information about good information here. Number one, 저는 과학을 좋아합니다. Is there any word means I like science? 좋아합니다 means like, right? I like science. We don't know he or she likes science or not, right? B. Number two, 저는 요즘 열심히 공부합니다. 요즘 is about the time. 요즘 means these days, recently, 최근에. 요즘에 okay? 열심히 공부합니다. Study her. Is it true? Alright. So here's a keyword hint for the number two. 날마다 mean every day. Every day I go to the library and study. So it means I study a lot these days, right? Because when do I have the test? Next Tuesday, right? That's right. Number three, 이번 주에 과학 시험이 있습니다. 이번 mean this. 다음 mean next. So different time, right? Different time. I opened the answer. Number four, 저는 화요일마다 땡땡땡마다 mean every, right? 화요일, Tuesday, every Tuesday. Every Tuesday, do I have difficult test? No, not every Tuesday. Next Tuesday, I have only the science test. Not every Tuesday. It doesn't mean, it didn't mention anything about, you know, every week. Tuesday, I mean. So B, the right answer will be number two. Let's move number three. Okay, here we go. 누나가 지난달에 고향으로 돌아갔습니다. 누나는 저에게 컴퓨터를 주었습니다. 그 컴퓨터는 커서 좋습니다. Alright, we can find here two people, right? 누나 and my older sister, and then 저 meets me, right? So 누나 and we need to find what did Nuna do and what did I do, right? Okay, first, Nuna. Nuna가 지난달에 고향으로 돌아갔습니다. 돌아갔습니다. Return, go back, alright? To where? 고향으로. 고향 means where you were born is hometown, right? Hometown. And then when? 지난달에, this is key point, right? 지난달, 달 mean month, right? 지난 mean past, last month, okay? Last month, my older sister went back to the hometown, okay? And 누나는 저에게, 누나는 저에게 컴퓨터를 주었습니다. So what did Nuna do? 주었습니다. Gave what? Computer to whom? 저에게. To me, right? So my older sister gave me a computer. 그 컴퓨터는 So, 그 컴퓨터 me, the computer my sister gave me, right? 커서 좋습니다. 좋습니다 mean good. So, this is good. So, why? 커서 mean will be the reason. 커서, big is huge, big. So, you know, the big screen, if you are seeing me and really big monitor, it will be good for you, right? Alright, so we find out all the information here. Let's find which is correct. Number one, 저는 컴퓨터를 샀습니다. 샀습니다. 사다. You know, 사다 mean buy. I bought a computer, new computer. Is there anything about a new computer? No. This is computer about, you know, computer. This is about the computer, but the computer my older sister gave me. So it's not new, old computer, right? The B. Number two, 저는 이 컴퓨터가 마음에 듭니다. 마음에 들다 mean 좋아요, 좋다, like, right? Like. So we can change. 저는 이 컴퓨터가 좋습니다. 좋아합니다. Okay? So is it true?
Yeah, because I like this computer. Why? Because this computer is big, huge. It's correct. Number three, 저는 고향에 큰 컴퓨터가 있습니다. 아, 저는 큰 컴퓨터가 있습니다. It's correct, right? But 어디에? Where? 고향에. 고향 mean hometown. So do I have big computer at my hometown? B is not true. I have big computer right now, and then I'm not at the hometown now. How do we know about that? Because my sister went back to the hometown. Mean I'm not. I'm here, and my sister went back to right. B number four. 저는 누나에게 컴퓨터를 주었습니다. 저는 누나에게 컴퓨터를 주었습니다. I gave computer to my sister. B 누나가 저에게 컴퓨터를 주었습니다. That'll be fine. Okay, so right answer is number two. Don't forget 마음에 듭니다. Mean like. Okay. Number four. 저는 기타를 배웁니다. 주말마다 학원에 가서 기타를 연습합니다. 가끔 어머니가 학원에 와서 구경을 합니다. Alright, here's the key word. You know, here's the main people. 저, 나, it's me, and my mother, my mom, right? So what do I do? 저는 기타를 배웁니다. 기타 is one of the music instruments. Guitar, right? Guitar. I 배웁니다. I learn guitar. I'm learning guitar. How to play guitar. And 주말마다, 이거마다, don't forget 마다 is every, right? 주말, it's a weekend, right? Saturday and Sunday. So every weekend, 학원에 가서 기타를 연습합니다. 기타 연습. Practice the guitar, right? Play the guitar. Where do I play the guitar practice? 학원. Music Institute, right? Music Institute. 가끔 mean maybe one or two times a week or sometimes three or four times a month. 가끔 means sometimes, okay, sometimes. Not often, not every day, not always, but not never. Sometimes, okay? Sometimes, 어머니가 학원에 와서 구경을 합니다. Sometimes, my mom 와서, okay. My mom 구경을 합니다. 구경 mean watch, okay? My mom watch me where? At the music institute, okay? Alright, number one, 어머니는 주말마다 학원에 옵니다. My mom, 주말마다, every 주말마다, every weekend. My mom comes every weekend? No, 가끔. Means nothing every weekend. Every weekend is very often, right? And then number two, 어머니는 기타 공부를 합니다. Does my mom learn about the guitar? Who learn about the guitar? Me, right? I'm learning how to play guitar. Me. Number three, 저는 학원에서 기타를 배웁니다. Okay, 저는 기타를 배웁니다. I learn guitar, right? Where? 학원에서. Is it true? Do I learn guitar, how to play guitar at the music institute? 기타를 배웁니다. 주말마다 학원에 가서. That's right. Number four. 저는 주말에는 학원에 가지 않습니다. 주말에는 학원에 가지 않아요. 가지 않아요 means no, not going, not didn't, doesn't go, don't go. So, but 주말마다 학원에 가서. So when do I learn the guitar? Only during the weekends, right? So it's not true. So right answer will be number three. All right, let's move number five. I think we have on today's lesson, we have seven questions. Okay, seven questions. So cheer up, we have only three more questions here. So number five.
오늘 저녁에 친구가 옵니다. 그래서 아침에 음식도 사고 집도 청소했습니다. 회사가 끝나면 집에 일찍 가서 음식을 준비할 겁니다.
So first of all, we should find the word about frequency, time.
오늘 저녁, okay? And 아침에,
and
회사가 끝나면, okay?
This is about time. So we need to make which is first. So 아침 is the first. First, what did I do already? What I did already, right? And number 회사가 끝나면 is next. And then 오늘 저녁 is third, the last one.
오늘 저녁에 친구가 옵니다.
So 친구 is friend, 옵니다, come. So where will my friend come? It means come to my house. Okay, come to my house.
When?
Tonight.
오늘 저녁.
Tonight. Okay. 그래서 so what I did already for for my friend. 아침에 음식도 사고. This is about what I did in the morning, right? Already. 음식도 사고.
The food. Food shopping, okay, food shopping.
And 집도 청소했습니다.
Cleaning the house, cleaning the house.
And 회사가 끝나면 after working,
maybe 5 or 6 o'clock, 6 p.m.
회사가 끝나면 집에 일찍 가서 So this will be what I will do.
집에 일찍.
I go back home, come back home early, and 음식을 준비할 겁니다. 음식 준비 in cooking, okay? Preparing the food, cooking for my friend for the dinner, okay? So remember what I did already? And what will I do? What I will do?
음식 준비.
And 친구가 옵니다.
Good. My friend coming to my house.
Okay, let's find which is correct. Number one,
친구와 저녁을 먹을 겁니다.
So my friend will come to my house at tonight and at the evening, this evening. And I'm going to prepare food, right? Cooking means we're going to have dinner together, right? It's true, right? Number two,
저녁에 청소를 할 겁니다. 저녁에 청소를 할 겁니다.
I didn't do my homework yet, but I'm going to I'm going to clean my house in the evening. Is it true? B, I already cleaned my house in the morning, right? And then number three,
음식을 벌써.
Parsa means already. Already I cooked the food. No. Remember, this is 아침, morning. 오후,
afternoon and 저녁 in the evening and 밤 and night. I think I'm in the middle of in the afternoon, okay? So I already did in the morning and I'm going to do after work and in the evening. So I already prepared the food. It's not true because after work I'm still in the middle of working. So after work I'm going home early and cook the food, right? It's not correct. Number four, 친구가 음식을 사올 겁니다. So my friend, very friendly and nice guys, he will buy the food. Even though I invite him, it doesn't any, you know, it, there's anything about this and very, very bad, right? So it's not correct. Right answer with number one. My friend and I are going to have dinner together. Okay? Number six.
저는 마음이 아프고 힘들 때 선생님을 만납니다. 선생님을 만나서 제 생각을 선생님께 이야기합니다. 그러면 기분이 좋고 즐겁습니다.
Do you understand about this story? So who are in the story?
저, 나, I, and 선생님, my teacher. Okay?
We don't know what kind of teacher or just a teacher, my teacher. Okay?
So, 저는 마음이 아프고 힘들 때 when do I meet my teacher? When 마음이 아프고 feel sad, feel not good, feel bad or 힘들 때 mean you know, having a hard time or having difficulty. Okay?
그럴 때 선생님을 만납니다.
I meet my teacher. Okay?
선생님을 만나서 and meet and 선생님께 제 생각을 이야기합니다. I meet my teacher. Here,
so something, you know, skip, okay?
I meet my teacher and talk about my idea, my think, okay? To my teacher.
그러면 mean, 그러면 mean,
this is include many things about what I do, what I did. So what I did, what I do when I meet my teacher, I did think, talk about my thought, right? So after talking about my thought,
기분이 좋고 즐겁습니다.
It makes my feeling good, all right, and happy. Feel good, feel better, okay?
기분이 좋고, 기분 means feel. 기분이 좋고.
In English, we can say I feel good, but in Korean, 기분 will be the subject, all right? Okay? So 기분이 좋다. Feeling is good, like that.
즐겁습니다. Happy, pleased.
So 같은 것을 골라볼까요? Number one, 저는 선생님을 만나면 마음이 아픕니다. When I meet my teacher, I feel so sad because he's so poor and he doesn't have any money and jobs. I feel and he had a really hard time. I feel really bad, sad. Is it true?
No, it's not true.
When I feel not good, I meet my teacher, right?
Number two, 저는 선생님의 이야기를 잘 듣습니다.
I am a good listener. I am a good listener. No, here we go. Who talk? Who is talking? I'm talking. I'm talking. And who is listening? Teacher is listening. Okay? It's not correct.
Number three, 저는 힘들 때 선생님과 이야기를 합니다. 저는 힘들 때.
When I have hard time, difficulty,
힘들 때, here we go. 선생님과 이야기를 합니다.
I'm talking with my teacher. 선생님께 이야기를 합니다. 선생님과 이야기를 합니다. It's a little bit same meaning. Talk with my teacher, talk to my teacher. It's a little bit similar, right? Anyway, I talk and teacher listen, right? Okay. Here we go. Number four. 저는 기분이 좋을 때 선생님을 만납니다. Okay. Nobody knows when I feel good, I meet teacher or not. In this story, we cannot find out this, right? So only thing when I feel bad, I meet my teacher and talk about my thoughts. After a day, I feel getting better, right? Okay, we don't know about this. So number three will be the answer. Let me see. Oh, okay. This will be the last one, number seven.
오늘은 제 생... Oh my God! 오늘은 제 생일입니다. 그래서 형과 밥을 먹고 파티를 했습니다. 형은 저에게 셔츠를 사주었습니다.
Who are in the story? 형. And 저. 나. I, right? So my brother and I. This is a story about my brother and I. So, let's find about the time.
오늘,
today.
Today
and 제 생일입니다. 오늘, today is my 생일. What is 생일? Birthday. Today is my birthday. So, 그래서 so 형과 밥을 먹고 what did I do first? I 밥을 먹고 eat lunch or dinner, we don't know. Have some food. Have a meal. Have a meal with whom? 형과. With my brother. And 파티를 했습니다. 파티 mean party. We had birthday party, okay? And then 형은 저에게 to me에게 is to me. 저에게 셔츠를 사주었습니다. 사주었어요. Is buy for me, right? Buy to me. 형은 저에게 what did my brother buy for me? 셔츠, shirt. You know the shirt, right? The shirt, right? Okay. All right, let's find out which is correct. Number one, 저는 오늘 형 셔츠를 샀습니다. 형 셔츠 mean 형의 셔츠. 의 can be the skip. Okay? Can be skip. So 형 셔츠 mean 형의 셔츠. My brother's shirt. So did I buy? No, it's my birthday. So my brother bought the shirt for me, right? Number two,
저는 쇼핑을 하고 형과 식사를 했습니다. 형과 식사.
It's correct, right? I had a meal with my brother. But
저는 쇼핑을 하고
do I shop something? Do I went shopping?
No. I didn't buy anything, right? I didn't buy anything. B. Number three. 저는 생일 선물을 받았습니다. 받았습니다. Me.
Get. Got. Receive. Right? So, did I get birthday present?
Yeah. What is it?
Shirt. Right? My brother gave me a shirt. Right?
That's correct. The shirt is the 생일 선물. 생일 선물 is shirt.
Number four, 저는 가족과 생일 파티를 했습니다.
생일 파티를 했습니다. 파티를 했습니다.
Ah, that's right. I had a party. I had a birthday party. With whom?
There is Wimpleton. 가족과 형과.
Of course, 형 is the one of the family members, but a little bit different, right?
Because 가족
And family means not only one, you know, means all of the members of my family, right? So I only had a meal with my brother, not mother, father, or uncle, aunt, grandma, right? So this is not the perfect, best answer. The answer will be number three. So we all finish about the question, but practice, but here's a little bit we need to think about this. This is about grammar, and then very, very often expression at the test. So today we study about all the frequency words, right? Frequency. So 매일 아침, 매일 오전, 매일 오후, 매일 저녁. If there's a 매일, mean every day. So 매일 아침, every morning. 매일 오전, every morning. It's the same. 아침 and 오전 in Korean, same word. 아침. Morning. Okay, it's the same word, morning. Means same meaning, morning. Every morning, right? 매일 오후, every afternoon. 매일 저녁, every evening or every night. 매일 밤, okay? And then 띵띵마다, 마다, 마다 mean every again, okay? 일요일마다, every Sunday. 월요일마다, every Monday. 수요일마다, every Wednesday, okay? 아침마다, 저녁마다, every morning, every night, every evening. 밤마다, every night, 날마다, every days, 주말마다, every weekend, okay? It's all the same, every, okay? And then this is about 이번 주, 다음 주, 지난주. 이번 주 mean this week, next week, last week, past. So this week, next week, last week, right? 이번, 저번. 이번, 다음, 지난주. We can use 이번 주 일요일, 이번 주 수요일, 다음 주 토요일, 지난주 금요일. We can use that. And then 오늘, 어제, 내일. In today, yesterday, tomorrow. Very basic word about the time, right? 오늘 아침. This morning, 오늘 저녁, this night, this evening, tonight, this night, oh my god, tonight, or this evening, 어제 저녁, last night, last evening, 내일 아침, next morning, okay, next morning, okay? It's a little bit difficult for you, but you should write down on your notebook and then please memorize about the frequency and time vocabulary. Okay. So that's it for today. We only have 7 questions, but a little bit difficult, and there's a lot of things to explain to you. Next time we're going to continue about type 4, the reading part. Okay, so there will be more some questions for you here. So hopefully see you next time and have a great day. 감사합니다.